All right, guys, I'm just going to show you my, right here's the rubber butt pad, and there's just plastic on the end of the stock, which I like that. And the fine checkering work on the stock. It does have some laser engraving on it. You know, pretty much even on the bottom. This is a Bobwhite CZ 20 gauge double barrel side by side. And it's got a nice engraving on the forearm. And there's the 28 inch barrel. And it does have, let's see if I can get down the barrel. It's got, comes with 5 chokes. There's 2 of them in there. Okay.
What's up, YouTube? Hot Lead Retired here. All right, guys. About a month ago, I've been sick for like a month, man. Sinuses. But anyway, about a month ago, I bought a double barrel side-by-side shotgun. And I'm not really a shotgun fan. I only own one other shotgun. But I've always been kind of a fan of the side-by-side double barrels. Like the coach guns, just any double barrel, basically. I just think they look cool. But anyway, I was up in West Virginia getting some NFA engraving done on my Mossberg. And I saw this gun hanging on the wall, and they had a price tag for $450. And it looked like it was in great condition. So when I talked to the guy, he said, yeah, this guy bought 5 CZs. I don't know how many years ago, a few years back, but they'd never been fired. And he was trying to make a profit on them. He was going to hold them for a long time, thinking the price would shoot up and he would make some money. But really, that didn't work out. The price has gone up, but not enough where he could make any money. But anyway, so I didn't know it was new in the box, never been fired. And I noticed it still had the stickers on the barrel from CZ. They'd never been peeled off. The gun looked like it'd never been fired. So I asked the guy, I said, has this gun been fired? He said, no, it's new in the box. And it got everything in the box, 5 chokes, and everything comes in the box. And so I offered the guy $400 cash. He told me he couldn't do it because the gun's never been fired. It's brand new. And I'm like, well, I'll call you back in a minute. So the guy at the gun store said he would, the engraving cost for my gun was $50. So he said he would let me have the engraving free if I bought the gun. I said, okay, I'll do that. Cause that basically $400, right? So basically I got it for $400. If you count the $50 the gun store guy gave me off. But anyway, so let me tell you a little bit that I know about it. I don't know a whole lot about it. I shot it, I've only shot 6 shots through here. But when I first got this thing, guys, it was so hard to break down. It was so hard. And it was so tight, man. But after I shot the 6 rounds through it, it loosened up a lot. So it's still tight, but I'd rather have it tight than loose, right, guys? You know what I mean? Anyway, it doesn't have ejectors. It's got extractors. It's got a chrome line chamber. This is 20 gauge with a 28 inch barrel. As you saw in the close-up video, it's got the engraving and stuff on it. It's got a tang safety, which is in a good spot. It doesn't kick very hard. It's 20 gauge. It's not too heavy. And I can't believe it's starting to rain out here, man. Raindrops in the sunshine. But anyway, I wanted to see how high up I could shoot a target floating in the air, so I was trying to figure out a way I could do that. I've shot skeet before, but I don't have a skeet thrower, and I don't know anybody that has one. But I come up with the idea of using helium balloons. I know that's funny. And it was about a 5 to 10 mile an hour wind, so they moved pretty good. But I took some twine and tied on the balloon, and I ran it through the eye on my steel plate rack where I hang my steel plates. and I took a clothespin and tied on another piece of twine, and I just clamped that clothespin at the bottom of the balloon string. And then I had my son pull the string, and I'd let it float up, and it was till I let it float up until I didn't want to go so far. I wanted to make sure I hit it pretty much. So I let it go up about 25 yards, which is pushing my limits, I thought, because, you know, first time shooting a gun, never shot a double barrel before. But I hit it. I hit every shot. So now I would like to see him go higher. And see, I want to see how high to go and I miss. You know what I mean? So next time I'll do that. But I'll put the footage at the end of this video if you're curious to watch it. At the end of the footage, I had him do a double balloon release. So I had two balloons to hit. So, anyway. I had the camera sitting on a tripod, so you could only see about half of me in the frame shooting at it, because the distance and everything, I wanted to make sure I got the balloons in the camera view. So, about the best I could do, I guess. It's not too bad. Before I get off here, let me tell you about what I got coming up, guys. I'm wanting, my gun store's having a Ruger, the people from Ruger are coming down, and we're gonna have like a Ruger show only at this gun show. And he's gonna have free food. The Ruger is bringing their cowboy exhibition shooting team, and they're gonna be shooting cowboy guns. And they're gonna be bringing a lot of dealer exclusive tallow and Lipsy and all that stuff. And I've been wanting to get a Ruger 454 Super Blackhawk. And they're hard to find, guys. I live in a small area and we don't have a lot of choices. So hopefully, it's not gonna be until May, Mother's Day weekend. So hopefully, I'm not gonna buy another gun or anything until I see this gun show. Because the gun I'm wanting is going to be, they're going to have specials running on all these guns too, by the way. So I'm hoping to save a little money, but I'm probably looking anywhere between $1,200 and $1,400 for that Ruger that I'm wanting. But I got it narrowed down to three. My first choice is the 454 because I can shoot 45 long coal with it. My second choice is the Ruger Super Blackhawk in 480. I really don't want that because you can only shoot 480 rounds through it. But if they don't have the 454, I'm getting the 480. All right, my third choice is the Ruger Vaquero in the tallow model. It's got a lot of nice engraving on it and stuff. So, and it runs a little over 1,000. I'm not sure how much, probably 1,100, maybe a little more. But that's what I'm looking at down the line here, guys. And I've been working on a sawed-off shotgun. But every time I get ready to put my $200 paperwork in, I end up running across these gun deals unexpectedly, and it's taking all my money. So I've been putting that on the back burner for 2 months. But I got it ready to go, except for the barrel. So, anyway. All right, guys, I'm out of here this time. See y'all later. Thanks for watching. Hot Later Tired out.